Dear students, today I am going to teach you a short story, After the Sunset, written by Bhupal. Let's know about the author. Bhupal was born in 1953. He has written short stories and children's books in the Telugu language. He has Ambalabanda, a short story collection, to his credit. The short story Poddumikinanka in Telugu is translated into English by Professor K. Damodar Rao. The story is originally written in Telugu by Bhupal. Bhupal is a stage artist and actor in movies like Kumaram Bheem and Das. He has written short stories and children books in Telugu, and he received Kendra Sahitya Academy Award for Children's Literature, Uggupalu, in the year 2001. This story highlights the issues of inequality and terrorism in the society. The writer weaves the story skillfully around a real incident occurred in Hyderabad. This story illustrates that ordinary people are the victims and the worst sufferers. The writer, Bhupal, brings out the theme of conflict between the rich and the poor and the treatment meted out to Pushpalata. Pushpalata is the protagonist of the story. She represents the poor in the society. She is asked to wait at the Andhra Bank in Koti by her husband. She is asked to wait at the Andhra Bank in Koti by her husband. Their plan is to buy a sari and a blouse piece for her cousin to gift at pre-wedding ceremony. Her husband works in a poultry farm located in Taramatipeta near Hayat Nagar, and he promises her to meet at Koti, Hyderabad. As per her husband's instructions, she goes to Uppal and take 1000 rupees from his uncle. Then she takes a bus from Uppal to Koti and gets down at the lane opposite to Medical College, Koti. From there, she reaches Koti Andhra Bank on foot. While waiting for her husband, Pushpalata recollects past events happened at her illa's village, Shamshabad. Pushpalata's in-laws belong to Shamshabad. While waiting for her husband, Pushpalata recollects past events happened at her illa's village, Shamshabad. They sold their 5 acres of land to Guntur police sar for 10 lakh rupees, which was spent for his sister's wedding and ailing father medical expenses. Apart from the 5 acres, Guntur policeman bought 40 more acres there. The policeman built a fence around the land, constructed sheds and a small factory. Pushpalata and her husband, along with other sellers, worked as laborers in their own farmland. Within a year, property rates soared sky high. She was abused by the landlord for asking him to give some more money to the sellers as the land rates soared sky high. One day, on seeing the Guntur sir car, she went to his office and requested him to show mercy by arranging some more money as the land prices soared. There, she was insulted by the manager. She threw her left chappal in the direction of Guntur sir. Hurling curses, she left the place. Pushpalata's thoughts are disrupted suddenly as she hears a huge blast and people are running helter-skelter. Knowing it is a bomb blast, she runs to Gokul Chat and witnesses the deadly wounded and scattered dead bodies on the road. Pushpalata is worried a lot, since she is clueless on her husband's whereabouts. Searching for her husband, she reaches home at 10 p.m. and collapses on the floor, weeping loudly as she couldn't find him even at home. For summary, visit my blog. Link is given in the description.